Welcome, John. Thank you so much for sharing your time with us today. I believe you've become the ambassador for Eurosport for the MotoGP. John Abraham needs no introduction. Famous movie star and avid biker. I think that's the side of you that we know. So, MotoGP, do you also sit like us on the edge of the sofa and scream and shout and yell through every race? Is it sacrosanct to watch?
Yeah, it's quite exciting. I wouldn't say I'm even half as good as a driver as you are, but definitely I'm a fan. I enjoy the races. I've been Renuka. I've been following them for like 30 plus years. So it's, for me, it's just an added advantage today that I'm endorsing MotoGP with Eurosport and Discovery Plus. So I'm fortunate. Let me put it that way.
It's been a crazy season. I mean, this time Marquez coming back after his injuries and winning the German GP, that Zarco Oliveira battle. Yeah. So what's been your pick? What's been your favorite moment, this season?
I think Marquez winning in the German GP because he's the king of the ring, like he's popularly called. And his comeback was very emotional. Of course, my heart is always with Valentino Rossi. I think it works for him and for Petronas Yamaha that he moves away from them next year. But it's been a joy. And I think I've been really fortunate to have been watching Rossi from the start of my MotoGP viewing life. I've in fact been to races where Rossi's raced. I went to Brno in the Czech Republic. I went to Sepang and I saw him race, and it was lovely. I met him. So it's been really, really special. But I think as of today, it's become so competitive, Renuka. The difference between, when you see the qualifying, the first and the 20th guy, it's 0.8 seconds.
Yeah.
Where you call the last guy a slow bike, So it's a lot of fun, and I love watching Quartararo now, the young French kid.
Yeah, but what about him taking his chest protector and flinging it off onto a live racetrack?
That was crazy, but I think he got stuck. There was something that wasn't right here, and he tried to pull it out, and that was quite crazy. And the other race also where he was first and then he landed up 13 because of his arm pump issue. He had arm pump surgery. Yeah, but Quartararo is very, very interesting to watch. And I don't know whether you saw, after one of the races, he tried to do a golf victory thing and just couldn't get it. But it's fun to watch these young kids, yeah.
So you pretty much answered my next question, which was going to be about who's your favorite. It's very obviously Valentino Rossi.
Yeah.
You've been a Rossi fan always.
Always. From the start till now, yeah. I was a Doohan fan, a McDoohan fan, and then a Rossi fan, yeah.
Right.
You know, Rossi's been posting faster timings than he's ever posted, but he's still... is 15th and 14th on the grid.
Like you said, it's become so incredibly competitive.
It's very competitive, yeah.
You know, points of seconds matter, and it's completely crazy. And the younger guys, I guess, are just throwing it all in there.
They're crazy, yeah.
So it's, there has been increasing interest in India for MotoGP, but what do you think, people need to do to actually get more people to come in? Because motorsport still is seen as a very elitist sport in India.
Yeah.
So what do you think people need to do to kind of, make people realize, hey, this is crazy, fun action out there?
Like I was just doing an interview with Mrs. Megha Tata, who's the MD of Discovery Plus. And I think a similar question was asked to her. And I think she answered it rightly. She said it's the responsibility of the broadcaster to really push the sport. Mm. So I think it's a two-pronged approach. One is, I'm a fan of Autocar. I read Autocar. I watch your shows, Renuka. I love Hormuz Sorabji. When I buy a new car, I call up Hormuz Sorabji and I say, Hormuz, what should I do?
Yeah.
And, he guides me. So I think, when it's portals like yours and, platforms like yours that actually popularize it more, one is the broadcaster. But I also believe because it's such a, there's so much of investment that goes into the sport. I think it's important to get the grassroots right.
Yeah.
And if you get the grassroots right and you get, oil companies and motorcycle companies and car companies and tire companies to sponsor young kids from the age of 4 or 5 to get into the sport.
Yeah.
And then when you see a star out of India, then only will it be a more popular sport. Why is cricket and the IPL the most popular league and sport in the world and in India? It's because the best come from India.
Yeah.
Why is ISL, the Indian Super League, not? because you don't have a champion football player like a Messi, a Neymar, a Mbappe, a Ronaldo from India.
Correct.
So unless your grassroots is really strong and you get a star rider, like I think you have the Arjun and the Kushmanis and you know the younger lord Jehan Daruwala. I tried watching one of his races on F2 and I think he stood fifth in that race. So he's really good.
Yeah.
But once he makes it into the pinnacle, that's when you start, that's when the viewership goes up.
Yeah. And do you think we'll ever see a MotoGP in India? An event?
Superbike was supposed to come to India 3 or 4 years ago. On the 18th of November, I think they were supposed to come into India. But I think the UP government then had some rule that it's entertainment, not
correct.
Sport. And I don't know where these guys function from. And anyway, so I think I would want to see the MotoGP come to India. I think Abud International Circuit, I've gone around the circuit. I think it's world class. Yeah. Correct me if I'm wrong, Renuka.
It is.
More than me.
Yeah.
And I went around it in a Mercedes and they took me for a... I found it amazing. I said, this is a world-class track. What's happening?
You haven't been rounded on a bike yet?
I've been to Brands Hatch and to Silverstone, Brno, Sepang on motorcycles.
Okay.
And I've done my second and third level California Superbike school.
Okay.
So I've done all that. But no, I've not ridden on the Bull International Circuit.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
Tell me, what's your prediction? Season comeback now after summer, Syrian GP. Who's going to win that?
Well, I mean, if you want to see young blood, I think Quartararo will be the world champion.
Okay.
I don't think Yuan Mir is going to win the world championship this time, though I think he's amongst the most consistent riders and Suzuki has got a great bike. I'd put my money on Quartararo.
Well, John's putting his money on Quartararo. Remember to tune in and watch that GP and see if he's going to be right about it. So get out there and start watching MotoGP.
Cheer for Rossi.
There you go. Cheer for Rossi, but Quartararo's winning.
Yeah.
Great. Thanks so much, John.
Thank you.
It's been a pleasure talking.
Thank you.